Air raid sirens in Kyiv as Russia's assault continues, wreaking havoc on surrounding cities and suburbs.
We don't have military bases or anything like that. Here are just civilians, workers. It is a village.
As the desperation in Ukraine grows, the US has approved more than $270 million in additional arms. But the Kremlin warns it is prepared to fire on any arms shipments. In Russian-controlled Melitopol, CCTV captures the moment the city's mayor is kidnapped by Russian troops.
The kidnapping of Melitopol's mayor isn't just a crime against an individual person or a specific society or against Ukraine. It's a crime against democracy as a whole.
Further east, a humanitarian crisis in the port city of Mariupol. Citizens facing dwindling water and food supplies. In the streets, tanks openly fire on residential buildings. This woman clutches her surviving child as she describes the horror of the attacks. With the fighting focused in the country's east, many are fleeing into the western city of Lviv, which has so far remained untouched.
There were Russian snipers on the roofs of houses. There was a house they could go to for humanitarian help, but on the way, there were Russian soldiers, or they were killed because missile fragments would hit them.
This enemy don't have any moral rules. They destroy all civilians, they destroy children. This is really terrible and horrible.
But with explosions on the outskirts of the city reported just hours ago, some Lviv residents fear it's only a matter of time before Russia arrives at their doorstep too.
10 News First senior reporter Ursula Heger joins us now from Lviv. Ursula, I believe it's been a very intense night there for you. Can you tell us what's been happening?
Well, yes, good evening, guys. This morning at around 3:30, the air raid siren went off again. It does this every morning around here, but this one was a bit different. There were three large explosions that rang out across the city just before dawn. There are conflicting reports at the moment as to what's happened. There seems to be some indication from one politician that a military base to the northwest of here has been hit. Another politician has remarked on Twitter that this was the Ukrainian air defence system stopping incoming Russian missiles. So there is a lot of confusion here at the moment. What is clear is that Russia is really intensifying its campaign in the west of the country. Lviv is a UNESCO heritage site. It's a beautiful old city, and they have been boarding it up over the past couple of days, wrapping up the statues in a desperate attempt to protect what they can from what they fear will be incoming attacks in coming days and weeks.
So there's been a sense, at least for the course of this war, that the west of the country might be safer. That's why so many thousands of people have fled to Lviv. Is there now a concern that actually it's no longer going to be safe?
Well, yes, and that might be part of Russia's strategy. There are a huge number of refugees in Lviv at the moment, around 200,000. There's obviously more, around 50,000 a day moving through the Lviv train station as they try to make it to the Poland border. But this is essentially the rear base, if you like, for people leaving the country. Because of its proximity to Poland, it's only about a 50-minute drive under normal circumstances. But at the moment, we are seeing just an incredible number of people try to leave the country. I heard one report that is taking people now 24 hours if they try to drive that 50 minutes to the border. Other people are managing to get there in 4 to 5 hours. So the times do vary. But essentially, this is just another example that nowhere in Ukraine is safe right now.
Ursula, in the past few weeks, we've heard some heartbreaking stories coming out of Ukraine. We understand that you spoke to a man who was signing up to fight who had to bid goodbye to his family.
Yes, this was utterly heartbreaking, if I'm honest. We spoke to Stas, who was 38 years old. He worked in logistics. He actually worked as a driver for an alcohol company. That's what he did as his normal job. And he was yesterday in the line. He was from Kharkiv. Everybody in the line that we filmed yesterday were refugees who were signing up to join the armed forces. His wife, Eren, and his baby, his 10-month-old baby, Nika, were both there. And it was quite it was devastating because the little baby is obviously smiling. She's happy. She doesn't understand what's going on. She thinks this is a fun day out. Whereas Aren was just crying quietly. She doesn't know what's going to happen to him. She doesn't know what's going to happen to her and her child. And this is just one of a number of heartbreaking stories that are going on in this country right now as people have to make the hardest of all choices.
Ursula Heger, we really appreciate you bringing us up to date. Please stay safe.
Thank you.